রবি ঠাকুর? কেমন ঠাকুর, মাটির নাকি কাঠের? এই কথাটা নেই লেখানে রুমুর সহজ পাঠে। মাটিরও নয়, কাঠেরও নয়, ঠাকুর তিনি প্রাণের। আজ 25শে বৈশাখ, আমাদের এই প্রাণের ঠাকুর রবি ঠাকুরের জন্মদিন।
হ্যালো এভরিওয়ান, ওয়েলকাম টু আওয়ার স্ক্রিবল সিক্রেটস, ওয়েলকাম টু এ নিউ ডে। টুডে ইজ 25শে বৈশাখ। ইউ অল মাইট বি ওয়ান্ডারিং আফটার দ্য শর্ট ইন্ট্রো দ্যাট হোয়াট ইজ টুডে, ওয়াই উই হ্যাভ ডেকোরেটেড দিস ডে ইন সাচ ওয়ে। ইয়েস, টুডে ইজ রবীন্দ্র জয়ন্তী, দ্য বার্থডে অফ রবীন্দ্রনাথ ঠাকুর। পিপল অফ বেঙ্গল অ্যান্ড ত্রিপুরা, উই অল ইউজ টু সেলিব্রেট দিস ডে টুগেদার, নট পার দ্য গ্রিগোরিয়ান ক্যালেন্ডার বাট পার দ্য বেঙ্গলি ক্যালেন্ডার অন দ্য 25th ডে অফ বৈশাখ। An eminent poet, visual artist, novelist, composer and playwright, Rabindranath Tagore is one of the biggest literary figure in India and the first Asian laureate to win the prestigious Nobel Prize in 1913. For his contributions to Indian literature and music, his life is celebrated with much favor on the occasion of Rabindra Jayanti. In the year 2011, the government of India had issued 5 rupees coin to mark the honor the 150th birth anniversary of Rabindranath.
Gurudev's birthday is celebrated ceremoniously across the world by holding a number of cultural programs in his memory. Play, dance, drama, poetry and songs, all written and composed by the legend himself, are performed on this day to show our gratitude towards Kobi Guru as Kobi Pranam. This year, because of the number of cases that are increasing in huge proportions, so few of us get together and remember Tagore through his songs, dance, recitations and short stories on his birthday.
Tagore pinned down Janaganamana, the national anthem of India. He also wrote the national anthem of Bangladesh, Amar Sonar Bangla. His lyrics and words move about in this emotion and thoughts of a Bengali mind. Perhaps each word can be felt. Rabindranath is a friend often, a next door boy, says all the emotions even before on confession. That way a Bengali reader is thankful to the poet.
Tagore's poems and songs carry the sweet fragrance of long sunshiny hours, so full of light, love and jasmine scent. Let's start today's program by welcoming the month of Boishakh by singing Boishakh, you are welcome, in the fresh air like the breath of a sage, to make an ill spring out, clean all the drivel that has accumulated over past years. Take away all the nostalgias, songs that are put behind. Let all sorrows swept away. Boishakh, you are welcome.
Ishwari 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 Ish
The poet Rabindranath Tagore was the founder of an institution that we know today as Vishwa Bharati University. It is situated at Santiniketan in the rural southern Bengal. The making of this institution was central to his concerns to the end of his life. Until independence, it was a college. Soon after independence, the institution was given the status of a central university in 1951 by an act of parliament. Rabindranath Tagore believed in open-air education and had reservations about any teaching done within four walls. This was due to his belief that walls represent the conditioning of the mind. So he devised a new system of learning in Vishwa Bharati with five students, including his eldest son and an equal number of teachers. Could you believe a school with five students and five teachers? Shantiniketan was lovingly modeled by Tagore on the principle of humanism, internationalism and a sustainable environment. There are many hidden chapters in our Kabi Guru's life. One such is explaining
now. সময় ইনফ্লুয়েঞ্জা জ্বর যুদ্ধ জ্বর নামে পরিচিত ছিল। বহু জায়গার মতো শান্তিনিকেতনেও সেই জ্বর ছড়িয়ে পড়ে। রামানন্দ চট্টোপাধ্যায়ের মেয়ে সীতা দেবীর পুণ্য স্মৃতি থেকে জানা যায় যে দেশে জ্বরের ফলে আশ্রমের বহু ছাত্রছাত্রী অসুস্থ হয়ে যায়। রবি ঠাকুর নিজে রোজ সেই ছাত্রছাত্রীদের হাসপাতালে দেখতে যেতেন। সীতা দেবীর লেখা থেকে জানা যায় সেবার কবিগুরু পঞ্চতিক্ত পাচন নামে এক ভেষজ প্রতিষেধক তৈরি করেন। তেউরি নিম গুলঞ্চ নিশিন্ধা এবং থানকুনি বেঁটে একসঙ্গে সব কটটা মিলিয়ে তৈরি হয়েছিল এই পাচন। রবীন্দ্রনাথ এই পাচন তৈরি করে খাওয়াতেন আশ্রমবাসীকে নিয়ম করে এবং আশ্চর্যজনকভাবে এই রোগের প্রকোপ অনেকটাই কমে যায় শান্তিনিকেতন জুড়ে। রবীন্দ্রনাথ চিকিৎসক দ্বিজেন্দ্রনাথ মৈত্রকে 1918 29 ডিসেম্বর চিঠিতে লিখছেন, ছাত্র সৌভাগ্যক্রমে সকলেই ভালো আছে, তাদের সকলকেই রোজ পঞ্চতিক্ত পাচন খাওয়ায়। আমার বিশ্বাস সেই জন্য তাদের মধ্যে একটি কেশও হয়নি, অথচ তারা অধিকাংশ সংক্রমণের কেন্দ্র থেকে রোগগ্রস্ত পরিবার থেকে এসেছে। হ্যাঁ, রবীন্দ্রনাথ ঠাকুর এইভাবে অনেক ভেষজ।
Tagore was appreciative of cultural expression in dancing. For him, dance was the way of communication of souls. He put his sole efforts to make his students learn the aspects of all the Indian classical and folk dances. And he appointed 10 gurus in Santiniketan. He founded the base of a dance art that is flexible in all structure and opens to adaptation and was used to present his dance dramas in and out of Santiniketan. The dance form is called Ravindra Nitya. The main complement of Ravindra Nitya is Ravindra Sangeet, the song written by Rabindranath Tagore. One such song explains, when there is no one to take the initiative to bring a change, you can be the starting person, and that soon others will follow you.
a child prodigy, Tagore's literary progress developed at age 5, with his first poem being published at age 12. From that point onwards, his 2,233 poems further lyricized as songs and were compiled in a book named Gitobitan, which means Garden of Songs, a staple in every Bengali household, much like salt, an absence of either, strongly inflicting tasteless monotony. It therefore comes as no surprise that his next piece of literature, Gitanjali, made him the first and only Indian to win a Nobel Prize in the field of literature. Gitanjali is an allegorical poem because under its surface meaning, we can discover another meaning, a deep spiritual significance. Each and every detail here stands for something. Here the beggar is every man, while the king of all kings is God. God is not only the giver, he is also a beggar. What God demands from man is complete self-surrender. Man must make the supreme sacrifice of his complete self to God without reservation. Through this complete self-surrender, the union between and man the king and of God.
I had gone a begging from door to door in the village path, when thy golden chariot appeared in the distance like a gorgeous dream, and I wondered, who was the king of all kings? My hopes rose high, and methought my evil days were at an end, and I stood waiting for alms to be given unasked, and for wealth scattered on all sides of the dust. The chariot stopped where I stood. The glance fell on me, and thou comest down with a smile. I felt that the luck of my life had come at last. Then of a sudden, thou didst hold out thy right hand and say, what hast thou to give to me? Ah, what a kingly gest was it, open the palm to a beggar to beg. I was confused and stood undecided. And then from my wallet, I slowly took out the least little gram of gold and gave it to him. But how great my surprise when the day's end, I emptied my bag on the floor and find a least gram of gold among the poor heap. I bitterly wept and wept and wished that I had had the heart to give thee my all. Thank you. Song of Offerings.
Even though Tagore is not with us, his presence can be felt through his work, like he conveys to the reader in a poem from his book, The Gardener. In the joy of your heart, may you feel the living joy that sang one spring morning, sending a glad voice across 100 years.